Let's start. Soften the back, soften the neck, open the head, and sink in the dantian. But there's one thing we have to keep in mind with the qi shi. It is not an opening position, it is an activating movement. It activates the orbits, the smaller heavenly orbit and the larger heavenly orbit alike. That means that the hands, as the arms, I'm sorry, as an extension of the body, are part of the yang qi yin qi connection as well. Yang qi on the outside and on the top, yin qi on the inside and, well, the bottom. Yang qi, of course, continuing over the back, spreading over the back, the neck, the face, until into the mouth, the upper palate of the mouth. Why is that so important? Because that is what you do with the opening action of Tai Chi. So we have two visually almost the same type of movement, the opening and the closing, the activation and the cooling down, so to speak. The bringing things together, that's what Tai Chi Shoshu means. It does not mean that you end, it means that you put everything back into its proper place. The opening of the orbits has consequences for the way you move. It's not just moving up, moving down, as you see happen so often. You start through the back, just like the first Qigong actually, only you go higher. The first Qigong just pumps up the Yang Qi till somewhere in between the shoulder blades, and now you go all the way over the head. So the hands have to adjust the height as well, going slightly forward because you're pulling the Qi over the head, then slightly downward because the Yang Qi is not finished yet. And then you, almost invisible to somebody who doesn't know, you switch. Notice, again, I can't emphasize this enough, notice the shape of the hand. The index finger is slightly up, the thumb down. I can physically feel the skin of this part. Not severely, I just barely feel it. And as little as possible, but I want to be aware of it. So first, when I rise, I do not only rise over the back, but through the outside of my arms as well. So once I reach more or less this location in my idea, or when I'm better in my actual awareness, then I am more or less here as well, on the outside of the fingers, fingertips, that coincides with this. And then I slightly go down, going to the palm, the face, into the mouth, and that's where I switch. So actually I do a bit like this, so now I feel physically this, and by adjusting the wrist I can move that sensation, my awareness of that sensation, from here to there, going all the way there. Here, I don't know why, but you can't feel, at least I can't, obtain a physical awareness. But if you just continue the idea of the flow, then you can pick it up here. And then by using the hands, slightly protruding the chest, not too much. The back shouldn't be hollow, but you want the chest to be forward, and then you can guide the qi down with the help of your hands. That's the small heavenly orbit. The small heavenly orbit is in between flesh and skin. You know, we've been practicing and we've been talking about making, freeing up the space between the skin and the flesh. We're in the third Qigong, in the sixth Qigong, and now is your time to do something with it. So, I know this is difficult, but you can have an actual awareness of free space in between skin and flesh. That's where you guide the chi through the back, in between skin and flesh, through the neck, which is difficult, the back of the head, over the head, outside of the arms, into the palms, face upper palate, shift to the tongue, through the tongue, the throat, going here, the upper chest, push down, and once you reach the soft part, the abdomen relaxes. And when you reach the chi high point, slightly below the navel, that's where you do your next thing, because that's where the chi, it does not go down at the front, it enters to the dantian and through the center of the body goes down again to the huiyin point, right in between the genitals and the anus. So that's the smaller heavenly orbit, but this exercise does both, the smaller and the larger. How is that possible? Well, simply because what a lot of people do not understand, but that's, we are talking about a smaller heavenly orbit and a larger heavenly orbit with the limbs included, but it's not the same orbit made bigger. There are two different orbits happening at the same time and at a different layer of chi. So the smaller heavenly orbit underneath the skin, the larger heavenly orbit outside. This is really important. And again, if you don't feel anything, don't worry about that. No, it will come, but it's just so that you know why I am so specific about this movement, because if you move, you just move up and down, nothing happens. You have to guide with the mind. Don't guide, try to guide the chi. You can't feel the chi, but try to feel how you make space at the back, between the flesh and the skin, higher and higher and higher, and then you reach the neck, and then the back of the head. You guide with your hands the chi over the head, down, into the mouth, and then you switch through the tongue, the throat, outside the chest bone, underneath the skin, of course, into the soft part. But now, after the first time, you slightly sink. So the yin goes lower. You start at high, small heavenly orbit, but now you go down, meaning that, of course, the smaller heavenly orbit continues its own path, but you go down through the legs towards the feet as well, and then on the outside of the legs you rise again, and then the back, and again it's a different layer, literally. So you can have both at the same time. You do not have to focus on one specifically, as long as you move with the idea of orbiting. And this time you will focus on the smaller heavenly orbit, the other time on the larger. Don't worry about that. The reason, we'll continue in a moment, the reason why I bring this forward is because it is a very important theme in Tai Chi movement, at least in our school. That means that let's take the first step, that through the outside and the back of the legs, the yang qi rises through the back, and then over the head, outside of the arms as well, over the head, front of the face. Then you switch to the inside of both arms and the jaw, the throat, and actually you go down and down, and you go into your next step. There is one main difference between Qigong and Tai Chi, which is well shown by this picture. Now, if the Yang Qi rises, it starts small underneath the feet, going up through the outside of the legs, back of the legs, the back, up, all the way forward. So that is more or less exactly how this picture is. The Yang Qi, the white, is going up through the back, and then there it becomes large. But this is also where the Yin Qi already starts. So there where the Yang Qi is at its fullest, there is already a little bit of Yin Qi. And when you go down, which is actually, again, really according to this picture, but visually you'll have to turn this around. So then it's not a circle anymore. But that is, maybe you can see it on the smaller, on the leg camera, but it goes up underneath the feet, outside, up through the back, over the head, and there it is full, which is the upgoing fish. Now when it goes down, it starts small as well, here, inside of the arms. And then it goes down like this, there. And then now I guide it with my arms. It becomes full in the legs. So it's actually a mirror image of this one, thus completing the larger heavenly orbit, which really visually follows the yin and yang sign, but again with this one turned like that. So that's what you open up when you start. Now about the closing. We'll practice it separately at the end, but now so that you know what we are practicing. In the opening, the activation, you went through the back, over the head, outside of the arms, inside of the arms, front of the face, the throat. With the hands, you guide the chi at the chest and into the abdomen. Now, at the end, it's visually almost the same, because you were moving, and then from this position at the end of the form, it goes out. But now you go slightly wider, so that you feel the inside. And then by using the inside of your arms and the front of your face, you gather the chi towards the upper chest, and then by using the hands, you guide the chi down at the front of the chest and into the abdomen. So what you get is you open up, which is of course done by raising the yang chi through the back, but you focus mainly on the inside of the arms and the face, bringing the chi back to the upper chest. Then by using the hands, you guide and facilitate the chi down and down, and you gather. Now if I make this very picturesque, then you could say that, and this is how you sometimes see it in some Tai Chi styles, that the opening, the activation, is done like that, then going back there, because the Yang Qi goes up, and then actually there has to be this, it has to be a bit rounder, but of course it is ritualized and then people forget why they make the movement. So that's the activation, and the closing movement does not have that. It does not have that going back. It only has that up. Well, it does have, and then it guides down. But it's wider, because you have to, so to speak, envelop the chi in front of you, guide it back first here, down, and into the abdomen. Okay, long talk about opening and closing. The closing is not relevant in the Tai Chi steps. What is relevant is one more thing, and then we'll start. I use this picture as an example, where the Yang Qi rises. That's the orbit. Small orbit, large orbit, the one you choose or connect to. But there is a main difference between Qigong and Tai Chi. In, of course, Tai Chi is a fighting art, Qigong is not, and that has consequences. In Qigong, you just make the circulation. Round and round and round and round and round and round, continuously. In Tai Chi, you have, I have no word for it, action moments. That means that's where the position is. That's where something happens, ideally. That is where yang and yin, or yin and yang, come together as well. And that's where you slow down for a moment. So you rise through the back, over the head. Then this is where the position is. And now I sink through the legs, but still a rising yang qi component, very strong. I sink through the legs because there is a starting yin. But I am full of rising energy because there is still yang. And that's where my position becomes strong. Because if you take the center as a starting point, then now we have generated two types of motion. Downward, because we are sinking, that's which is a downward sensation from here through the legs into the feet, into the earth. But the rising sensation was already there because we were making that movement. So these two motions, from here to there, from here to there, if they happen at the same time and they collide and connect exactly, then it is actually, it becomes an expansion of the dantian. There. So that's at the yang side. Of course, there is a yin side as well. This is a bit more difficult to practice now because we have to practice on the spot. We cannot make steps in a row. But to show you, when you go down, sinking through the front, and the body connects to that, the inside of the legs, and now there is the yin at its fullest. There. But there is already a little bit of yang qi, which is actually because of my weight bouncing in the floor through my feet. And of course, if I'm really standing correct, I'm not bending forward and things like that, then I can feel how my, well, dantian abdomen actually bounces through the legs and through the feet on the floor as well, like a basketball. So there is that bounce. And that's what happens here. That's the moment down there. So there's the bounce. There's the expansion. In between, starting from the bounce, there is a rising yang qi through the back, over the head, outside of the arms as well. There's the expansion. I switch to the front, sinking, bounce, and it starts again. And then the last thing, in order to generate, in order to be able to being able to generate that orbit, we just use a general yang qi over the entire back and a general yin qi through the entire front. But as you know, that's more or less the roof, a large surface, the entire back or the entire front. And a roof is supported by beams. And these beams are in the back, the dumai, at the front, the renmai. Now, the dumai and is a yang, the yang qi meridian. The renmai is the yin qi meridian. And there is a difference. Yang qi is hot and strong. It pushes, it forces. That means that where the heat is concentrated, it dries everything out which surrounds the heat. And that's exactly what has happened around the dumai. That's why you have a backbone, which is brittle, it can break. But that means that you have to be really careful and don't think about helping the yang qi up. That's not necessary. It will come up all by itself, but you have to facilitate by the brittle parts of the dumai, placing them exactly on top of one another. So when you are standing there, one of the things you are doing is adjusting the backbone, if you like. Doesn't matter how you phrase it, as long as you feel something warm coming up through the spine, and it will warm itself up, because you have to place, where can it go? And everybody is built different with its own deficiencies. For instance, my personal thing is, if I do so, if I correct the dumai, if I facilitate the dumai, the rising of the yang qi, then my body will rotate slightly away from the hips. My shoulders will rotate a bit like that. Apparently, there is a twist in my yang qi trajectory. Anyway, that's too much detail. What I mean to say is that when you move up, then only move up. So do not move up and rotate at the same time, because you will break, so to speak, the dumai. First you move up, you can tilt like this, yeah, but stay straight. And then you still can move up, and only when you have passed the head and you reach the yin side, then you can slightly rotate, because the yin side is, well, like water, and it can twirl a little bit. So that's why you have this always going down, has some curves in the motion, going up straight and solid. Remember that. Good. Now, I promise no theory. I totally broke that promise. So now we're going to do some steps.